I'm Commander Mark Peterson, and this year I have the honor and privilege to command the Independence Day Parade. This parade this year will be held to commemorate the 56th anniversary of our independence. And this year we plan to have approximately 1,000 persons from various uniform organizations. The armed units this year will be drawn from the Barbados Defense Force, which comprises Barbados Coast Guard, the Barbados Regiment, and the Corps of Women. We will also have the Barbados Cadet Corps and also the Barbados Police Service. The unarmed units are drawn from eclectic mix of uniform organizations, namely the Barbados Boy Scout Association, the Girl Guides Association of Barbados, the Barbados Landship, the Barbados Youth Advance Corps, the Barbados Fire Service, the National Conservation Commission, the Government Security Guards, and the Barbados Prison Service, just to name a few. Also on parade this year will be the multi-troop of the Barbados Police Service and the mass band of the Barbados Police Service and the Barbados Defence Force. The parade will be broken down into various phases, and just to give you a condensed version of the parade, the first phase of the parade will commence with the arrival of Her Excellency, the President of Barbados, and that would occur approximately at 0800 hours in the morning. Thereafter, I will report the status of the troops on parade and invite Her Excellency to inspect the members of the parade. Thereafter, we will pay compliments to Her Excellency in the form of a march pass. The armed units will march pass in slow and quick time. The unarmed units will march pass in quick time only. And once that phase is completed, the march pass that is, we will go into phase three, which will be a display, a cultural display, with the mass band of the Barbados Police Service, the Barbados Defense Force. Also alongside them will be the National Cultural Foundation. Once that is completed, we're going to, which is unique this year, the troops will march off the parade ground in anticipation of the next phase of the parade. And this is where we will go into the national awards, presentation of leadership badges to all head girls and head boys of all private and public secondary schools, or private and public schools in Barbados. We'll also go into the national awards ceremony. Thereafter, we will have the address to the nation with the Honourable Prime Minister of Barbados. And then to close out that phase of the parade, you'll have a presentation by a local artist, a very popular artist. So I invite you to come out and support and see who this individual is. Once that phase of the parade or the presentation is completed, the troops will be marched back onto the parade ground, where we go into the final phase of the parade. And this is where we do the salute to the nation, and that essentially culminates the aspect of the parade. Once that is completed, we're going to have the ceremonial march through Bridgetown, which takes us, both armed and unarmed organizations, through Fontibel, down through Broad Street, and we will pay compliments to the Her Excellency, the Prime Minister of Barbados, and members of Cabinet in Hero Square before we march to our final destination for the dismissal phase of the parade. I will invite members of the public, since this is our first full parade since 2019, through the years 2020 and 2021, we did have parades, but those were very condensed versions of the parade. This year promises to be a very spectacular parade, and I invite all Barbadians to come out and celebrate Barbados' independence.